This morning in the Roadshow Kitchen, we are getting tips from the pros from GoProvidence.com, and Chef Phyllis Arffa from Blaze East Side joins us to make a great summer colorful dish, fish tacos.
Fish tacos, yeah, great for the summer. Outside in the yard, you know, set up a little taco bar.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody can pick their own ingredients. We have pico de gallo, guacamole, mango salsa, sour cream, lime, cilantro, jalapeno. So it's all fresh and beautiful ingredients.
Excellent. And what are some of the spices that you're using today, too?
So this is our Cajun dust, mm-hmm. and this is cumin, coriander, salt, and pepper, and then we always have to have some garlic, right?
Absolutely, absolutely. And talk about, too, the variety, because like you said, maybe some people don't like a certain ingredient, but that's the best part about these tacos.
Well, so we're making fish tacos, but mm-hmm. I also have some chicken here because somebody doesn't eat fish, so we have to take care
of
everybody.
We won't mention who that is.
You could put steak in there, you could put pork in there, you could do whatever you like, whatever ingredients that you like.
Yeah, and these are all simple, fresh ingredients, and that's, I mean, to me, fish tacos are always so fresh and light and colorful,
so you don't
feel all weighted down by them. And how are we going to be preparing the fish today? Are we frying them in a pan?
Or? Yeah, we're going to be searing it. If you're doing it in your yard, you can grill it, throw it right on the grill, you know?
Oh, yeah.
But we're going to be blackening it in a pan.
Okay, excellent. So many options. Make sure you have this on your menu, maybe even tonight. Grab a pen and a pencil, write down all the ingredients. We'll start cooking it up in just a bit. Back to you.
Thanks.
Mary, everything is getting ready to, we're going to make some pico de gallo. We're here with Chef Phyllis from Blaze Restaurant on the east side. Glad to have you here.
How you doing
today? It's good to have you here, yes. And we are going to, we have all our ingredients here. We got tomatoes, onions, and we're getting ready to get started, right?
Right.
Okay.
So we're going to start by, I have some minced garlic, but we're going to make it a little bit smaller just so you don't get that hard garlic bite in the raw pico. So you put it there, put a little salt on it.
Alright. Little pinch of salt?
A little pinch of salt.
Okay.
And then a little bit more.
A little more.
And then you just want to rub that with the knife to get the like I said, to get that rough garlic flavor out of there.
Okay.
Do a little circles with it. There you go.
Like
rub
this.
It in. There you go.
Good.
And then chop chop.
Okay.
Chop chop. Okay. So then we can add that to the bowl. Not all of that. Maybe a third or a half.
Yeah. That in?
That's beautiful.
This.
Perfect.
Okay,
right on the side there, because we're going to put a little lime juice on it. So we're going to do a double whammy on it.
Okay.
We're going to put a little lime juice on here also to, then that begins cooking it a little bit with the acid.
Okay.
And that way you definitely don't get that harsh garlic taste.
So
now we're going to dice some onion.
All right. Now what's the best way?
You want to dice it really small.
Okay.
So, as small as you can go. There you go. Do like a little back and forth motion with that, There you go. It's like almost like elliptical. Motion. Okay, that's good.
Good. Okay, now we can dice these up?
Yeah. Right. We're going to just use this part right here. We don't need that.
All
right.
So dice these up?
Not too much,
Okay.
Dice that up. Chop that up.
I'm not going to be cooking with
you. I can see you do this every day.
I'm not going to be cooking with you, Phyllis.
Now we want to try to get them all the same size, so we try to get them smaller.
Yeah, that's what we're trying to do, Phyllis. Doesn't seem to be working out so hot. This was more of the segment for Michaela.
Yeah, because people don't want big pieces of onion. Okay, that's good. So now try and get like the smallest ones you got there, and just
Okay, scoop these up.
Knock those right in there.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go. Perfect.
Put that in there.
Perfect.
Scoop that in. Okay.
That's great. Now we're gonna just slide that over a little bit, and you're gonna dice your tomato. We're just gonna dice a little more. We already have some, but just add a little bit more in there.
Okay, we'll do this.
That's good, that's good.
And then dice this up.
Dice that up, so you go the opposite direction, right?
Okay.
There you go.
Okay,
we're going to give you a little knife skill lesson after
this. Yeah, we need skill lessons.
There you go.
All right, we are going to throw our tomatoes in. This may not have been the thing for me to do.
So, all right,
we're going to mix it all up.
Tomatoes.
And we're going to...
Jalapeno, cilantro, little cumin, coriander.
And we're good to go.
All right. Salt and pepper.
We've got all our ingredients together. We'll
there
be back in
go.
Just a little bit.
All right.
We are back in the Roadshow Kitchen this morning. GoProvidence.com. Chef Phyllis is here from Blaze East Side. We're making fish tacos.
So we're going to do three.
No more chopping.
He's got to finish the pico eating.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
So he's going to finish chopping and put all the ingredients in there. I'm going to make the blackened catfish.
Okay.
And you're going to build a taco. So we have some nice fresh catfish here. And this is our Cajun dust seasoning that we use at Blaze.
Mm-hmm.
And
what goes into the Cajun dust?
I can't tell you. I have to tell
secret
you.
Stuff?
It's a secret
can't
recipe.
Tell you that.
Forget I asked.
I can't tell you that. So a nice hot pan. You want it to get blackened.
Okay.
All right.
that sizzle.
And if you do it at home, you know, like I said, you can do it right on the grill. And catfish is a really good fish. It's a firm white fish.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a really good fish for, can you turn this fan on?
Yeah, well, we'll get the smoke out of there.
Little, maybe turn
it
down
for
just
a minute.
A smidge. So it's a really good fish for, you know, for blackening. Mm-hmm. We're going to let that go a little longer.
All right. Yeah, about how long are we going to cook these for? Because they seem to
People always ask that question, how long do I cook it?
Mm-hmm.
Until it's blackened, until it's done. It could be 5 minutes. It could be 6 minutes. It depends on your stove, your grill.
Mm-hmm.
So everything, you know, so you might I might tell you 5 minutes, and then you have to go a little longer. You got to check it at 5 minutes, right?
Okay, as long as it's blackened.
I already have some made, so we can get the tacos going.
Great.
And we'll pop this one into the oven.
I've determined I've been giving people.
Now, Will?
And I
what is your technique called?
I don't know what my technique is, but I do know I've been giving busy work.
Okay, so we're gonna grab some. We're gonna grab some corn tortillas.
Okay, now have we heated these?
Yes, I've already heated them. What you can do, we can do that over here also.
Okay,
here's the raw ones. So you could just throw one on there, so we can just see how it gets.
Right
what happens
the,
to it? Right on there.
Okay.
And again, you could do that right on your grill. Oh, careful. We have some tongs. We have a tongs. Here you go. You get a tongs.
This
there
is a
go.
Dangerous day for Will and myself.
So you just want to get a little char on it, just to get a little flavor.
Or
and be careful. Do it quickly so it doesn't break. We can do another one. We can do another one. We have more anyway.
All right. All right. Well,
so
about
that.
Well,
why don't we use this one?
One of yours.
Why don't we use that one? Okay. So now this is your taco. You have all these ingredients here. You can build it whatever you like. You put in.
Okay.
You put in there. You know, you start with your lettuce, and then that's your bed, and then you put your fish, your protein, if you want chicken or.
Okay. Yeah. Let's do some fish.
Some fish.
Yum. And what other kind, I mean, if we don't have, we're using catfish, you said, right? So what other kinds of fish would be good in a fish taco?
You can really use anything.
Okay.
I like, you know.
Are there ones that are going to hold together?
Like, you know what would really be great? A mango salsa taco with some grilled tuna. That would be really yummy.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's like anything that your imagination thinks of.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everybody likes different things, so.
Delicious. We got some guacamole going on.
Some guacamole.
Will?
Sour cream.
Should I check in on you again?
You look okay.
That looks pretty good, actually. Do we have to taste it? Let's give it a little taste.
I hope people are doubting me.
I don't know. Let's see. Well, the taste test is the thing.
Oh, here it is.
Oh, very good.
Yay!
You got it.
You did it.
Very good.
Here we go.
Very good.
Okay.
So this is a queso blanco. It's a white Mexican cheese, hard cheese. It's kind of like Parmesan cheese. It gives it that distinct flavor. It's put a little more. It's really yummy.
Go for it.
That kind of gives it that distinct flavor.
I have a full taco here.
Yeah. Do you want to try? I made one for you, Will.
You made one
chicken taco for you.
Oh, chicken taco for me. All right,
I can't even fold this up. This is what happens.
Will, do you want to build yours?
I like too many ingredients on my taco.
This one has chicken. Do you want to put all this other stuff in there?
Sure. Yeah. Well, you know, I'll grab some from right here. I'll put a little of this stuff in here.
Okay.
This is huge. It's all falling out, but I'm going to eat it anyways. Woo!
Yeah, let me give you a plate, Will.
Too much lime juice.
Here we go. Plate.
Put
you don't
want to
put any of the other stuff in there?
No, we're good.
No, you're good.
Yeah, we're
so I can't even talk right now.
Yeah.
It's delicious.
That's a good way to start your day,
fresh
right?
Fresh flavors.
That's really good.
Oh my gosh, everything is so good. And it's colorful.
Mm-hmm.
Did you try? Did you taste test yours?
It's good.
All right, and then tell everyone what's going on at the restaurant. You got some.
So we have Mother's Day coming up. Mm-hmm. We'll be doing a Mother's Day brunch, and you know we're always on Facebook and Twitter. You can follow us at Blaze Restaurants on Facebook, and Twitter is Blaze East Side 1. We're always having. We have a 3-course lunch for $12.95. We always have specials going on. Right now we're going to be doing a dinner for two, Tuesday and Wednesday.
Nice.
Can't wait. We're going to have to check it out and try it. Make sure you follow them and make these at home. I think we're going to eat a little bit more. Don't forget, you can find the recipe on WPRI.com.